What's up, y'all? It's the Mind Tonight. It's time for another one. So, here we go again. I can't believe this, that we gotta have keep having this conversation, but we're gonna have it yet again. And this is really like a trend, like freaking serious problem in regards to Disney, but Hollywood overall has the same problem. Y'all have zero, and when I say zero, creative talent in Hollywood, it's like baffling to me. We are now up to like 50,000 versions of Peter Pan, but yep, here we are again. And it's, of course, you know what's happening, right? Of course, Peter's changed, Tinkerbell's changed, the Lost Boys are changed, and the thing that gets me, and I know people are gonna be like, "Oh, you're just being an internal instant foe." I got a solution for y'all. We're gonna get into that in 2 seconds, but just the fact that the Peter Pan that came out when I was a kid from the 1950s Disney, as a classic, right? It really didn't have to change much. I get it. It might have been, I guess you could say, is not politically correct now with some of the things they did. Who cares? Who cares? Okay? But here's my solution, right? Here's my solution. And this took me just a quick Google search. African fairy tales. Look what just pops up here. So, before I get the whole internalized instant-phobe, I want you to understand how instant-phobe Disney and Hollywood per se is. Because instead of you doing something simple as, I don't know, I just did a quick Google search. How about you do one of these and make these into a movie? I'm confused that you got to constantly come back to this. Change Peter Pan, changing, Tinkerbell. The Lost Boys are not Lost Boys anymore. It's Lost Children. Which is crazy because not like they didn't have girls inside the Peter Pan story. But, okay. Lost Boys. Lost Girls. Ah, who cares about storylines? Who cares about that? But back to my point. This right here alone shows the true instant phobia when it comes to Hollywood and Disney specifically, because you don't have faith in doing an actual African story fairy tale and making that be something to, I don't know, since you want to have representation and have little black girls and little black boys see themselves, how about you let them see themselves in the actual African folklore? I'm just putting it out there. Okay? I'm not the one who's rehashing Peter Pan for the 50,000th time. What are you going to tell in that story other than, oh, we made people brown and black? That's all you're doing, that you're changing in the story. That's it. Because the story's got to be the same. I'm confused. Am I the one that's a little out of here? I don't know. But because to me, I don't know. To me, it seems like you guys are instaphobes. Because I'm just saying. Simple Google search. That's all I did. You can have whatever fairy tale you want that doesn't have to be a rehash of something that is, I don't know, European. Because you know what? It seems to me, big shout out to Young Ripper, it seems like you guys only have legitimacy when it comes to European folklores. European folklores, white superheroes, you name it. It seems like that's the only thing that's legitimately a story when I literally just Googled African fairy tales and all this popped up. Right? So, who's really the bad guy here? And are you tired of the rehashes, reboots, remakes? Nothing original.
Let me know how you feel about that.
Like, share, subscribe. If you want to support the channel, you can hit that super thanks. And remember, you can't be good, you're good at it. Peace. I heard that the best bet is Monopoly. Ain't no space control.